Hello everyone, in today's GeoSnap, I'm going to show you how to create and calculate hidden fields in Survey123 Connect. First, when adding hidden fields, you need to ask yourself what you plan to do with them. In this GeoSnap, I will show you not only how to show questions later on based on certain answers, but I will also show you how to calculate hidden fields for later use in other calculations. To start, if you have a question that you want to hide and then show later based on another answer, you can start by using either the relevant field or the Esri body visible field. The Esri body visible field will be used if you don't want your answers to be cleared if they are hidden. For example, if a user makes a question visible with a specific answer and then realizes that question is incorrect and changes it, it will rehide the other question, but the value will stay the same and not be deleted. Whereas in the relevant, it clears the answer. Most users use the relevant field unless there is another scenario in which you need it to not be cleared. In this survey, I use the relevant field with this equation, where I put the question name at the beginning and equal to the answer I want the other question to show as when clicked. This is the result. I select yes, and it will show the next question accordingly. If you would like to hide fields in Survey123 for calculations or values, these questions can be hidden by either using the hidden appearance, the hidden question type, or the calculate question type. The hidden appearance can be used for questions that are grabbing values, like a user's email or a user's name. Alternatively, the hidden or the calculate question types should be used for values that will be used in other questions. For example, I can use the calculate field to calculate my radius, but then use a hidden appearance to calculate my area, which is the value I actually want to be recorded. In this example, I have used a hidden calculate question that calculates my radius from the diameter, and then uses this answer to calculate my area for the circle. These are the equations that I used. Other than the ones I just showed you today, there are so many different ways you can use these hidden fields in Survey123. If you'd like to learn more about them, feel free to use the links in the description. I'm excited to see where you take these hidden fields in the future with your surveys.